This is Hina, the voice behind Dr. Teeth. Before you proceed to the video, how about hitting the bell icon to get notified every single time we upload a new video? And hey, you can also check out our playlist on our channel for more awesome videos. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Got it.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. I hope you all are doing fine. Today we are going to learn a technique of root canal shaping, and that is the step back technique. There are various other techniques also, like the crown down technique or the step down technique or crown down pressureless technique, double flare technique, balanced force technique. But in this particular video, we are going to focus on the step back technique. Okay, so the step back technique is also called as the telescopic technique. Let us focus on the literal meaning of the word step back. For example, if I was here and I went all the way till here, but I decided to come back to a certain position, let's suppose here. So what I did, I took a step backward. So step back means you are progressing forward and then coming backward. So here the same thing happens. We have file here. So we go all the way apically, okay, till here, let's say, and then we gradually proceed backward. Means first of all, we will prepare the apical portion, and then we will prepare the middle of the canal, and then we will prepare the coronal most of the canal. So we have already reached the apical portion, and then we are progressing backward. That is why it is called the step back technique. Okay, so if you remember it this way, you will never forget. All right, now let us go through the steps of the step back technique. So first of all, what we need to do. So we all know that cleaning and shaping begins with the debridement of the canal, okay, and then we determine the exact working length. So the first step is we determine the working length, okay. Then what we do, we take number 10 file, let us suppose this is the file number 10, and then we go all the way till the working length, okay. Let us suppose the working length is 20 mm. So we'll take the number 10 file and go all the way till the working length. And let me draw a canal here so that it gets easier to visualize. So what you do, you engage this file on the walls, right? So let us suppose we are taking this wall into consideration. So you engage the file to this wall, and then when you engage the file, you will apply lateral pressure, and then you withdraw the file, okay? So when you withdraw the file, this entire wall has been shaped, or you have started giving shape to this wall. So the process is repeated through the entire canal, and that is why it is called as the circumferential filing. Okay, we are filing throughout the circumference of the canal. After number 10 file, you will irrigate the canal with irrigating solution. That is a very important step and has to be done. You know, be liberal in that. Do a lot of irrigation because it removes the debris and also, you know, lubricates the canal so that when you insert the instrument, there are less chances of breaking. Okay, now after 10, we go to number 15 file, and then again we go till the working length, and then we prepare it till 15. Okay, and then again we do circumferential filing, irrigation, then we go till 25. So usually the apical third is enlarged to develop the apical stop at 25 file, size 25 file. So this will be our master apical file. After this, we will start the step back procedure. Okay, so till now, we were increasing the size of the file, but the working length was same. Now in step back, what we will do, we have to go backward, right? So we will decrease the working length, but the file size will increase as usual. So next we take number 30 file, but now we will go till 19 mm only. Then we take 35 number file and we go 18 mm. We take 40 number file, we go 17 mm. Okay, and in between these we have a step, and that is called as recapitulation. And after 35, we again will do recapitulation. I'll tell you what is recapitulation in a while. Recapitulation means you will go back to the master apical file Here, in this case, it is 25. You will take the 25 number file and you will go all the way till the working length. So after 30, you will go back to 25. After 35, you will again go back to 25. And similarly, after 40, you will again go back. So this is done to maintain the patency of the canard, okay? Because while we are preparing, let's say, this portion or say this portion, this area which we have already prepared, it is kind of getting blocked by the dentinal shavings or the debris. So to maintain the patency or to make sure that the canal is not blocked, we do a step that is recapitulation. Okay, also using the master apical file, we do circumferential filing. So this will help us create space coronally so that when we do obturation, we have ample amount of space for lateral compaction. So we do circumferential filing with the help of master apical file so that we can refine the steps we have created using the step back method. Now, one question that must be coming in your mind is that how much can we increase the file size, right? Can we go all the way till the last number file we're having? No. What we do, usually after we get the master apical file, we will go at least 3 to 4 larger files, okay, and then stop. So keep in mind, we have to do recapitulation in between the step back procedure, and also keep in mind that we have to do copious irrigation. Both these things are very important. So I hope you found the video helpful. If yes, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do that before you leave the video. In the next video, we'll study about the crown down technique. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.